And it's good to plant things which to have things flowering throughout the year. So they've always got nectar and pollen from spring to the autumn. Be helpful.
I think compared to last year, I've noticed quite a lot more bees this year personally.
All right.
There's also an app which is still going, isn't it?
The Bee Count is finished.
Okay, well, next year. It's a thing that runs every year with Friends of the Earth, Great British Bee Count, and basically you can record your bee sightings and take pictures of the bees, and it'll identify them for you, and it helps just build a profile and data of all the bees around the UK and helps people analyse what's going on and how we can help them. Which one's this?
Dry grains. Oh, they're going.
Yeah. There's some different things.
These
are just the fruits and
the
vegetables.
I think it's just emphasising the seasonal thing. Kale for the spring, strawberry for the summer, butter beans for the summer, and the autumn, and raspberries for winter. So just to give that spread over the seasons.
Then we've got Create Bee Hotels, like I've said, just an example of what this might look like with the kids, just sort of long, tube-like things that bees are to nest in.
That'd be the solitary bees, by the way.
Don't use nucleus. Like I said, or herbicides and things like that. There's, don't know if anyone's heard of glyphosate, if I remember how to say, but that's a bit of a controversial herbicide. The EU, everyone thought the license wouldn't be renewed for that the year just gone, but actually they've renewed it for 5 years. Basically the problem with that is the main ingredient is known to be carcinogenic but also harmful to bees, so they affect bees' flight paths and getting back to their nests, and I think that's
mostly they're not good.
They're not good, basically. But since that action and the EU deciding to renew that, individual countries around the EU, such as France, have decided that they're actually just going to ban it anyway. You know, it doesn't matter if it comes from the EU, that they're going to outrightly ban it within the next 3 years anyway. So, but the UK is actually quite in support of it at the moment, as is Germany. So, but individual countries are, you know, have their opinions and are doing things like that. Grow some fruit, like I said. To be part of the Bee Friendly Scheme. Yep.
You know when you see council workers go straight into Brexit?
Are they? Do you say they are?
We
don't know. We've been trying to find out what the council is spraying.
Yeah.
They say that they use the least possible and that they're very, very careful and it's all entirely safe. But probably Maria knows more about that than I do. But,
I'm the same as you. It's a hard one, isn't it? Because we do have, you know, there are lots of us, and we do have to live here. I would happily ban everything out there. I would happily go around B&Q and scoop all of everything off the shelves. Okay. But I think the councils are genuinely bought into no reason. Most people who work in the past department, the councils like nature,
yes,
and they don't want to do it. But it's a change, isn't it? We're a cultural change. Like, the people here were all probably of the mind of, like, you know, of that sort of more environmental mindset. But, you know, the Cardiff Council do get complaints all the time that things are untidy.
Mm.
And of course, the thing is, other people pay the council
to want to do it. Yes. That's part of your totally different perception about what is an attractive environment. So it's not. They don't want to. So people don't think that the folding green is the ideal environment.
That's my picture of that new park, that picture, which actually looks better now than when I took that photo.
Yeah.
But you know, there is this, we're trying to change that fashion, if you like, for acres of green, mown grass to, you know, that's not good.
No. Tolerate a little bit of untidiness would be helpful.
Yes, we like untidy. Yes. Be lazy.
Yeah,
that's
exactly. Don't have to mow your lawn as much. Yeah, you know? No one likes doing that. It's a frequent thing. Basically that's what we have to say on that. And Poppy had a nice idea of just a mini little group discussion. What were we going
to
ask?
What can we do to support pollinators in Cardiff?
Yeah, if you just want to, like, discuss with someone next to you and for like a minute or two, and then maybe if you have any ideas or suggestions, just think, you know, maybe there's